Now let's start. This is rate monotonic scheduling algorithm. Here they are given three processes, T1, T2 and T3. Here capacities are given 3, 2 and 2. Period is given 20, 5 and 10. Capacity is indicated by C. Period is indicated by P. Okay. Now the first point here is how much time we need to schedule this algorithm. Okay. Scheduling time. Scheduling time can be got by the LCM of this periods, okay, 20, 5, 10, and we know that LCM of 20, 5, 10 is equals to 20. So by 20 units we can schedule this algorithm. Now the second point is priority. Okay, which task has to be executed first in this rate monotonic scheduling algorithm? Here whichever having the least period will have highest priority. So T2 is having the least period, okay, this is having first priority, okay, then followed by T3, okay, then followed by T1. So the priority is first T2 will execute, then T3 will execute, then T1 will execute, okay, this is the priority. Now coming to the scheduling part, here we will see here, see first T2 has to execute. Now here for the T2, period is 5, means for every 5 intervals, suppose, see, for every 5 intervals from 0 to 5, T2 has to execute 2 times, okay, for 2 units. Here for every 5 intervals, that is 0 to 5, it has to execute 2 units. Then from 5 to 10, it has to execute 2 units. Then from 10 to 15, it has to execute 2 units. Then 15 to 20, it has to execute 2 units. That is the meaning of this line. T2 having capacity 2 for a period of 5. It has to execute 2 units for every 5 intervals. Okay. Now the second is T3. T3 for every, okay, for every 10 units, it has to execute 2 times. Okay, now similarly for every 10 units T3 has to execute 2 units. Okay, now for the T1, for every 20 units it has to execute 3 units of time. For every 20 units it has to execute 3 units of time. Means from this we can clearly see that T1 will execute from the starting to ending scheduling only 3 units. Okay, T2 will execute 2 units in every 5 intervals of time. Okay, from 0 to 5 it execute 2, from 5 to 10 it execute 2, from 10 to 15 it will execute 2, and from 15 to 20 it will execute 2 times. Now T3, for every 10 units of time it will execute 2 times. Now we will schedule this. Okay, first the priority is T2, so T2 has to execute from, it will start here, okay, it will start here, it will execute this, then it has to again execute one more unit, because T2 it has to execute, capacity is 2, so it has to execute 2 units. So now in the interval 0 to 5, in the interval 0 to 5, this is completed. Now the second priority is T3, okay, here T3 has to execute 2 units, so here T3 will come for 2 units. It's clear. Now the T3 from 0 to 10, 2 units completed, right? Okay, now it has to execute T1. Okay, so T1 will execute 1 unit, but from 5, again see here, T2 has highest priority. T2 has highest priority, so at 5, T1 is preempted by T2, so T2 will come here. T2 will execute for 2 units, so thereby the 2 units of T2 will be completed. Okay, then T1 will come. Okay, T1, it will execute 3 units. Okay, first unit has already completed, then T1 second time, T1 third time, so T1 3 completed. Now 9 to 10, so there is nothing to execute, because from 0 to 10 T3 has executed, from 0 to 10, T2 executed 4 times, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now from 0 to 20, T1 has to execute 3 times. T1 executed 1 time, T1 executed 2 time, 3 time. So 9 to 10, there is nothing to execute. At 10, again T2 will start, because from 10 to 15, it has to execute 2 times. T2, here also, T2 will execute. Okay, now this is completed. Now, after T2, T3 should execute. Here from 10 to 20, T3 has to execute 2 units. So here T3 will come, again here T3 will come. And T1 will not participate in scheduling unit because it completed its execution. Okay, now T3 is also completed. So these 3 units is completed. Okay, now the leftover is 2 units of T2, it will start from 15. So 15, it will start T2 and T2. This is the scheduling of rate monotonic algorithm. So I will explain once again. The rate monotonic scheduling, which has 3 processors, okay, 3 processors, will have capacity and period. Capacity of T1 is 3, capacity of T2 is 2, capacity of T3 is 2. Okay, how much units of it can execute, okay, and the period is 20, 5 and 10. Period means for every regular intervals, it will start executing once again. Now, we need to find the LCM because we need to know the total time units to schedule this algorithm. And here in rate monotonic scheduling, we decide the priority based on the periods. Whichever period is low will have highest priority. So T2 period is very low compared to others. So this will have highest priority. So priority of T2 is greater than T3, then T1. Now, here T1 has to execute 3 units in a period of 20. So from 0 to 20, it will execute only 3 units. And T2 will execute 2 units for every 5. So T2 will execute 2 units for every 5 intervals. So from 0 to 5 it has to execute 2, from 5 to 10 it has to execute 2, from 10 to 15 it has to execute 2, and 15 to 20 it has to execute 2 times. Now T3, for 0 to 10 it has to execute 2 times. This also same, 10 to 20 it has to execute 2 times. We start with T2 because of its highest priority, okay, and it will execute 2 units and it will complete this portion. It will complete this portion. Between 0 to 5, 2 units, it complete this portion. Now, the second priority is T3. So, T3 will come and it will execute 2 units. Thereby, this portion gets completed. Okay. Now, T1 will come because T1 is the next priority. So, T1 also completed one portion at 5. This T2 will have highest priority. So, T1 will be preempted and T2 will come to the picture. So, T2 will execute these 2 units. Thereby, this will be completed. Now, T1 will execute. So this total 3 completed and T1 is out of the scheduling because it completed all these 3 unit scheduling. Now from 9 to 10 it's nothing. No, nothing scheduling is take place. At 10 T2 will participate and will complete 2 units. Okay. Then at 12 T3 will come and complete its 3 units. Okay. Then 14 to 15 no scheduling is there because no process is there. From 15 to 17, it will execute by T2, thereby it complete this. So, in the entire picture, it has to follow in a systematic manner and priority should be followed. Okay, this is rate monotonic scheduling.